I've just come back from where I've been, as you may well suppose. No doubt you feel astonished for to see me in these clothes. At present I'm a huntsman gay am I. And all the people smile at me when through the air I fly. When I say through the air I fly, of course, that's ridiculous. I'm not a flyer, you know, I'm a type dresser. That is my business. But it was very funny. There was a friend of mine, a man who I've borrowed a lot of money off of. He's down in the country, and he sent me an invitation. He said, dear old boy, he said, come down and spend a happy day at the hunt. So, well, I, as a matter of fact, didn't know what he meant. I thought, what's he gone hunting for? What is it? So I went down, he met me at the station, he got hold of my hand, he says, come along, old man, you're just in time for the meet. So I looked at him, I said, meet? Well, I said, have you opened a butcher shop? He said, no, the meat. Well, I thought to myself, well, perhaps this money, him coming into this money, it's driven him mad, so I took no notice. He said, you go up to the house and have some hunt breakfast. I thought, that's it. The meat's up at the house. So I went up to the house to hunt for the breakfast, and it wanted some hunting for. Dear, oh dear, there'd been some hounds there before me, and I hunted, and there wasn't a scrap of meat. And I thought, this is a joke. I thought, it's a bit of a joke, he's playing on me, and I take no notice. So he took me around and showed me the horse, my horse, well, not mine, but what they'd left for me. And you know, the moment that horse saw me, he seemed to have taken a liking to me. He turned round, and there was a look came over his face, a look as much as to say, good heavens, what is it? So I brought him out, or rather he brought me out, and I got on his back, and away we went, and he wouldn't go where they went. He knew I was a stranger. He took and showed me all round the fields and all through the conservatories, and then we came to a ditch. And of course I was all right then, because my friend said to me, when you come to a ditch, take it. So I took it. Well, I said took it. I took about a pint and a half. No more ditch for me. And while I was in the ditch up to my neck, he came up and he said, come along. Follow the scent. And I thought that was added insult to injury. He says, come on, we're going. I said, going where? Why, away we go, away we go, away we go. We don't know where we go, but still, well, I know we go away.